Thank you very much. Our partners in this noble partnership, starting with Dr. Peter Modoka, Chairman UAP Old Mutual, Faulu Foundation, and Faulu Microfinance. Mr. Peter Mwangi, the Group CEO, UAP Old Mutual Group. Mr. Apollo N. Joroge, the Managing Director, Faulu Microfinance Bank. The board, Mama Lucy, all the staff, Waheshimiwa, Wageni, Mabibi na Mabwana, good afternoon. Asante sana. Before I make my official speech from the County Government of Nairobi, I'd like to first recognize some Waheshimiwas who are here, and then maybe for 1 minute I'll invite the area MP also to make his few remarks. We have over there Honorable Mudeo, MCA Malango Kubwa. We have our Chief of Staff, Mr. Kamau Mungo, who played a very important role in the promotions. Mr. Sari, you've just spoken. We've got our County Askaris on my left, who are also going to be promoted very soon. We have our area MCA, who has just spoken before me. Let me now invite the area MP, Mr. Dewi, ambaye pia ni kijana mchapakazi, sio watu kupiga piga mdomo. Dewi hapa ametujengea police post, alikuja akatuomba kiwanja ya county tukampatie, amejenga police post, amejenga swimming pool ya shule, anapeana school uniforms bure kwa wanafunzi. And I remember even the Honorable Ken Okoth alijenga shule kubwa sana Kibra. Even Makadara when I was an MP, nimejenga mashule, Makadara Maternity Hospital. We have a road today which is called Sonko Road. You come from Nigeria here? Anyway, we'll come to that. Let me invite the area MP to make his few remarks, then I can proceed from there. Mheshimiwa Dewi Karimu.
Good afternoon, Your Excellency, all protocol observed. Hamjambo tena. First of all, Your Excellency, I'm very sorry for coming late. Na ni vile tu nimejua saa hii. But all in all, I want to say that we appreciate what you are doing. Especially, I'm talking on behalf of Embakasi West. And mimi kama mbunge wa Nairobi, I just want to say that I'm proud of what our governor is doing. Because within my constituency, we have the new bus terminus in pale Utaring. Wale wamepitia hapo wameona ile kazi governor anafanya. As you are speaking right now, we have a bridge that we are doing in 56. Bado governor anafanya hiyo. Estate ya Umoja, Umoja One only, we have like now 4 roads ongoing zinafanyika. Hapa Mama Lucy, tuko na new wing ile ilikuwa imekwama na inaendelea. So within Embakasi West, na bado sijaongea, our last born market in Nairobi, that is the new wakulima market ile iko pale mnaona, kazi ni kuisha inaisha. We have the fire station, nyinyi mumeona pia, pale fire station. Na hiyo yote mimi naongelea ya Embakasi West. So when people are saying that governor is not working, na wanaleta maneno mingi, I don't know, sijui yao ni wa Nairobi gadi, but for me, my Nairobi, that is Embakasi West, I'm very, very proud of what our governor is doing. So, Your Excellency, we are right behind you. We are proud of what you are doing. Na sisi ni wale wa job. Sisi ni wale wa job. Wale wa kelele, wacha wapige kelele. Tunajua raia, ndio watamua. But me, I'm very proud of what governor you are doing. Na wewe usitishike na hii maneno ya upuzi ya watu wanaongea ongea. So, thank you very much for what you are doing. We are here to say we support you. We are proud of what you are doing. Na tutaendelea kushikana na wewe, Your Excellency, to make this Nairobi a better place. Thank you very much and God bless you. And all of you, thank you. Dr. Musa, your staff, we are very proud of what you are doing. Despite the challenges, we are proud to say you are doing a tremendous job. Personally, I can tell you that I used to bring my dad here, my late dad here. And the services here, ukweli Dr. Musa, your team, wakina Gedaiga, have done tremendous job. So I'm proud of what you are doing. Na governor, wewe fanya job. Hai maneno ingine, wewe wachana nayo. Thank you very much. Welcome and God bless you.
Asanteni sana, now to my official speech, alafu tutaendelea na hiyo story ingine. I'm very happy to join you today for the launch of the patient queuing system at Mama Lucy Hospital. This hospital serves hundreds of people in Nairobi County and attend to around 1,000 patients daily and has an inpatient capacity of 134 beds. Nairobi County government has made a lot of effort to support the health sector, and this year we have dedicated 21% of our county annual budget to this important sector. We are also partnering with the national government to implement the Linda Mama Free Maternity Program and World Bank projects that have ensured funds flow to support health services in this great county of ours. Mama Lucy Kibaki Hospital is part of our four main hospital, county hospitals, and has benefited greatly from our focus on quality health care for all Nairobians. We have completed a fully fledged TB clinic and have installed an oxygen plant in this facility. We are currently completing the new hospital block, which is a 76-bed capacity. Today, we are launching the electronic patient queuing system in Mama Lucy for improved customer care and quality services. This hospital has multiple service delivery points where patients are served, and due to the high workload, long queues are frustrating and delaying service delivery. This project will therefore go a great length in easing and congestion and long queues. This patient queue management system will also increase operational efficiency and enhance the patient's experience and customer satisfaction. These include management of patient queues more efficiently and conveniently, system that allows real-time queue status information, reduce patient wait time and service time considerably, makes service areas less crowded with patients, clearly shows length of wait of each patient, real-time reporting allows efficient management of hospital services, makes operational tasks more systematic as doctors are alerted when waiting time exceeds. As a county government, we are determined to take health services to a higher level than we found it. We thank all our partners for their collaborations and support. In particular, let me thank in a very big way the management of Old Mutual for the noble support in this particular project which we are fully financed. Nikiendelea na hiyo mambo mengine, Mr. Chairman, we are very sorry because we started by having a tour of our hospital. But to our critics, whenever we do these tours in our hospitals, they think we are doing it for PR purposes. But it is always good to always engage with our patients, with various staff who are working here, so that we identify the various challenges the hospital management is facing, the patients, because I remember the money penda kuuliza mgonjwa uko na shida gani na naona na kama daktari anaogopa kusema anaona anaanza dungwa sindano angamie. But squeeze, I want to compliment our staff in all our hospitals kwa Nairobi City County, all our county public hospitals. There is a lot of improvement in this hospital. And Dr. Musa and the chief officer, the board, Mheshimiwa, ukiona hospitali inajaa watu kila siku, ujue services ya hospitali ni mzuri, it is not a challenge. Yes, yes. So the negative publicity about the media, hiyo muulize songo about publicity ya media. Magazeti jioni tunafungia nyama rais akisema hivi. They will talk during the day, they sleep at night, na Nairobi inasonga mbele.
Yes.
So you ignore such negative publicity. You just be focused, peana motivation za your staff, board, sija wana mkena Mombasa, mina wana mkena tu pekienu na ndege mkiogelea. Go with your staff, doctors, nurses. Yes. Yeah, we discuss about these challenges, kama kuna makosa imefanyika. What measures are you putting in place to ensure that problem ile imeletwa na media does not occur again in future? These are some of the initiatives we need to do with our staff. For all the hospitals, we'll also, when a chief officer, you talk to the other boards, in all our sub-county hospitals, ward hospitals, so mkuwe na engagement ya madaktari na manases kila saa. You will motivate their morale. Also to the staff, especially the nurses, I want to thank you in a very big way for the respect you showed us a few weeks ago when you were on strike. And it is within the constitution kugoma sengine kama mnadhulumiwa. Na solution ya strike si kupiga watu tear gas. Ulikuja demonstration, nikawapatia audience, tukakubaliana. And as your governor, I'm the one you really confirm, it was indeed true that mlikuwa mmedhulumiwa from 2013 without promotion. That was very wrong. Kwa hivyo, chief officer keep it up, chief of staff keep it up. Mandela na hiyo maneno na you make sure you agreement CPR. You implement it. Mkishindwa, you are the ones who will go home. And that is my motto of kufanya kazi. As we are going around, we have identified some challenges, especially from the dental department. The space we found there is too small, it is too congested. We have raised your issue. The board has raised the issue through Dr. Musa also and Mzewetu Hapa. We don't have a blood transfusion center here. We don't have an ICU center here. And I saw you, Bwana Chief Officer, taking notes. So instead of requesting for a single big use from our engineers, just do a complete request for the expansion of the dental center, for the construction of the blood transfusion center and the ICU center. So make that requisition together, then we will approve it when it comes to the council. Last time when we were here, there was a challenge of our TB center through the med soup of this hospital. We took your request. I'm happy to report that the TB center is now complete, ready for launching, and patients are being seen and treated. That is good job, keep it up. Kwa hivyo sisi ajira yetu ni maendeleo. Mzee Moyo alituambia na napenda kusema kila siku, siasa mbaya ni maisha mbaya. I'm happy. The important machines like MRI zinafanya kazi mzuri. Nimeenda kwa lab, umeona machines zinafanya kazi mzuri. I saw the kitchen is very clean. Hii hospitali hakuna mali kuna harufu mbaya. Keep it up even for that, our staff, nurses. Na ofisi yangu is open kwa kila mmoja wenu. My number iko kwa public. If there is a problem, that is our problem. Let us handle it together as a team tuhakikishe challenges kama hizo zitokee. On the staff recruitment, we had advertised last year, but the process was not complete because our county public service board, their term had lapsed because in the previous administration, the period didn't expire, and this affected the entire county government staff, even our inspectorate officers, enforcement officers, various staff, senior staff directors are in an acting capacity. But we re-advertised for the position of the County Public Service Board. Wamesha, they're in office now. Walikuwa Mombasa juzi for their retreats. Now they are ready, and this Friday, we are going to place our advert in our media, in our magazeti. Kwa hivyo, my request to the board, and the County Public Service Board, and the health officer, chief officer, you are here, the minister, chief of staff, those nurses who have been supporting us through the process ya locum, doctors, find a way through the law by giving them first priority for those particular jobs. also our jobless youth, mheshimiwa wale wako wengi Nairobi hapa, because of the same problem, we advertise for the inspectorate officers. We are recruiting over 1,000. Tuna recruit 200 traffic marshals, 200 firefighters. We have set budget aside for those particular positions. However, we are appealing that these jobs should be given to Nairobians, Kenyans who are residing in Nairobi. Tutafanya free and fair process, which shall involve all the MPs, all the MCS, all Nairobians, when we are conducting this exercise early next month. Again, maybe on kelele zile zilikuwa zinapigwa na wabunge, ni ndugu zetu, ni rafiki zetu, tunawapenda. Kitu hatupendi ni witch hunt. Usema there is no development in Nairobi. Usema revenue is being stolen in Nairobi. That is a total lie. Kwa sababu mahesabu zetu za Nairobi zinafanywa na kaunti zote na pia kwa national government. Zinafanywa na controller of budgets. And the controller of budget alirelease report yake early last month in 2019. Number one, Nairobi was the highest in terms of revenue collection. Our revenue increased from 2017-2018, we collected 10.1 million. This financial year 2017-2019, there was an increase of around 150 million. And in Nairobi, that is, we collected 10.22 billion. And in Nairobi City County Government, we do not handle physical cash. We do not spend money at source as provided for in Article 207 of our Constitution and the Public Finance Management Act. Whenever we collect our cash on daily basis, zinaenda kwa bank zetu. We don't collect. It is you taxpayers who bank this money direct to our commercial bank accounts, which is Cooperative Bank and National Bank. At close of business, every day, the money is wired to Treasury, to CBK. Hatugusi hata shilingi. And in CBK, hakuna mtu mjinga, with the systems that have been put in place by His Excellency the President, DCI yako pale, Central Bank yako pale, DPP yako pale, hakuna bank manager mjinga. Atakubali, anaona hii pesa kwa county na Robinson County Government, ati ya transfer kwa Sonko ama kwa bibi yake. There is what we call paper trail or money trail. Watu watashikwa na wataenda jela. So hii propaganda, tuachane nayo. Kuna experts ambao wanafanya hii mahesabu wametupatia hizo report, na siko kila mahali, wasomi wengi wako hapa, you can Google Auditors General Report 2018-2019 Revenue Collection Nairobi City County, utaipata hata kwa simu saa hizi. Kwa hivyo tu tunaongea na facts. Nataka kuambia ndugu zangu, I want to give you a very good example. I thank His Excellency the President, jana aliongea na akasema wabunge Nairobi wafanye kazi yao, sisi magavana MCS na wananchi tufanye kazi yetu. Lakini tumefungua milango for engagement, not kutusiana, not kukosoana bila facts. That will be very wrong. I want to give you a very good example, Mr. Theuri, and I want to support you in a very big way. I want to support also Mheshimiwa Jagwa, Mheshimiwa Babuino. Akona mind kama yako ya kufanya kazi, kuweka wananchi mbele. If you Google again, maybe kuna wale wamesahau kazi yao Mheshimiwa Theuri. You go to your Google, maybe after this meeting or when you're at home in the evening. Google Sonko versus Franklin Bett. Okay, Google your Sonko versus Franklin Bett. There was a question that I brought in Parliament on 23rd of November 2011 on traffic congestion on this altering road. Hii barabara ilikuwa moja, all the way from Jogoro Road, kukuja hapa, hii barabara ilikuwa ni moja. If you want to kukuja umoja, Komaro, Kayole, Kangundo Road, ilikuwa lazima utumie either Jogoro Road, kuja Outering Road, paka Kangundo Road, uingie, ndio uende umoja. Just to be brief, because hii ni waste of time, but I just want, because Theuri yako hapa, akasambaza injili kwa wenzake huko, wajue kazi yao ni nini. And that day I asked on 23rd November 2011, quick one, Mr. Speaker, sir, I beg to ask the Minister for Roads the following question by private notice. A. Is the minister aware of the frequent traffic snarl-ups on outering roads, especially at the Donholm and Kariobangi roundabouts? And what immediate and long-term measures will the government take to remedy the problem? B. What is the extent of losses, both in man hours and economically, resulting from the delays. The minister akajibu, mambo mingi ikakuja, wakasema wanaanza outering road. But tukasema hii mambo ya outering road now, when the minister stood again, if you go to paragraph 3, Sonko again. Mr. Speaker, I appreciate the good work the minister anafanya Nairobi, especially Makadara, wamerecarpet my bypass. Then there was another sub-question which asked, since outering road links Juja Road, Mumia South Road in Buruburu, within my constituency, Kangundo Road, Umoja, Jogo Road, Lungalunga Road within my constituency, and Airport North Road, which links the Mombasa Road, what urgent measures is the minister putting in place to ensure the construction of outering bypass in Anza? It starts. Then minister kaleta my story. Then this question was referred to the departmental committee. Minister kasema there is some money by the ADB bank, around 2 billion, which is not enough. Then we asked the 2 billion, if it's not enough, what is the government doing to ensure the construction of this outering road in Anza? Then the government through treasury, wakaweka pesa. This outering road in Anza is there. Kwa hiyo Google utapata hapo. Then, mambo sasa ya outering road, how the people were suffering. Nikiwa tu MP. I remember my friend, the current president Uhuru Kenyatta, was the minister for finance. We had some small money kwa CDF, which was not sufficient. Tukapeleka hii mapendekezo, na rais akatuongezea, when he was the minister for finance, another 285 million for what we call today the Sonko Road. Serikali ilikubali hii Sonko Road because of the role I played when I was an MP for construction of this particular important road. And I remember there was a lot of bad politics. There was a market, it was a Mutindwa market. Na wakati tulianza barabara from Metropolitan Hospital, ikafika BP hapo Shell, watu wakagoma, wakasema soko hii, na barabara inapita katikati, haiwezi toka. Tukakuja na proposal, tukasema, let us do some temporary sheds, modern sheds, so that we'll be selling along the barabara. Kuna wale walikubali. Na kuna wale wakakua incited, wakaleta siya sambaya, wakafanya demonstration paka bunge, wakasema Sonko must go, Sonko must go. It's all about the YouTube. Then nikawambia Sonko must go here. Na sisi tunataka development. Sasa ingine kama serikali tukifanya vitu, tunafanya vitu kwa atletia maendeleo, muone changes. What did we do after the Sonko must go? Iyo mambo ianze. Tulipomoa area barabara inapita by force. Tukasema tuwache siya sambaya. Kama sita rudi, kwa kitu wache nisirudi. But tufanya maendeleo. Tukabomoa hato moja ya soko, na hii Sonko Road ikapita. Na baada ya soko kuisha, watu wakaenda kalukano ya barabara na wengine wakaendelea na biashara zao. So at times when we take some bad decisions, hatufanyi kusema kazi yetu kama county government ni kupiga wananchi. Ni kusema kazi yetu kama serikali, lazima tuwafanyie maendeleo, tunajua kuna challenges ya barabara, ndio naona sengine hata kura, tukiwa na excess ya pesa, we give them money, kutusaidia sisi kama county government. Because at times, we must accept the challenges leo wananchi wanarisi. We must accept barabara ni mbovu kila mahali. We must accept we need to do drainages. We must accept kuna shida ya manyumba Nairobi. We must accept kuna umaskini Nairobi. Kila saa tukisema sisi ni viongozi, hakuna mtu akosawa. Na hizi shida ni zetu sote sisi kama wananchi na viongozi, MCS, wabunge. Tushirikiane, tuoneshe good leadership, tuweke our political differences aside, tufanyie Nairobi wa kawaida kazi. Kwa hivyo mimi sitaki kuongea mambo mingi, nitakomea hapo, but once again, I want to thank you very much Bwana Chairman, let me shake your hand. Bwana CEO, thank you very much for the partnership ili ambaye mmekuonesha hapa Mama Lucy. Na sisi you count on our support in case of anything in future, we are there to work with you for the betterment of the people of Nairobi itself. Thank you very much, may God bless you.
Thank you. of a queue management system to this facility, made in September by the UAP Old Mutual Foundation, of which have been I was the founder and the chairman way back in 2014. Our focus on supporting the improvement of access to quality health is something that we value a lot. We have strong commitment in supporting communities in the areas that we do our business. Our commitment is also to the care and stand that we do with the communities across Africa.